the new one thing out there, Mara is getting ready for Gervonta Tank Davis. Tomorrow, both fighters are going to face off. It's going to be the first time they're really facing off. They never really got to know each other. But they're going to share the ring here in Los Angeles on February 9th at StubHub. I'm sure the event is almost sold out if it's not sold out already. And tickets are not that expensive, starting at $30. I'm gonna find out more. It's on Showtime, right?
Yeah.
Regular Showtime, not pay-per-view. Regular Showtime. Regular Showtime, not
pay-per-view. Regular Showtime.
Do you know who's walking you out?
I have no idea.
People are asking, to be determined.
Who?
They're asking who's walking you out.
Oh, okay, yeah. I don't know yet.
Adler told me he thought Charlo won the fight.
On which one?
They're asking, what do you think of the Charlo fight?
Karabov, close fight. I think Karabov deserves more of a rematch.
Yeah. Than Tony Harrison?
Tony Harrison, he had to, because he wants that title back, you know? Won the fight.
I thought Charlo's won.
Charlo's, right?
I think, I'll be honest with you, in boxing, when fans or media members don't like a certain fighter, it doesn't matter what they do in the ring, they look for that crack because they don't like their personality. I like them.
I'll tell you one thing. Jermall against Karabov, that was a tough fight.
Bro. It was a tough fight.
It was a close fight. People are giving him credit, less credit than he deserves. He fought a talented fighter, bro. Karabov is no...
And a short notice. And he prepared for a mover in Willie Monroe Jr. moves.
Bro, it was difficult. Like, it's difficult to fight those opponents, man.
Yeah.
He was so tactic. He was, like, really, really smart. And definitely that last round, you know, did him well.
Yeah, I thought he did great.
But good fights. Good wins for both of them. They're going to learn a lot. They recognized it. I've seen interviews where they're talking about, like, how disappointed they were because of, you know... the performance, but you have those fights, you know, you're not gonna look impressive all the time.
No, you can't look great every night, but your job, like Floyd
said, you know,
win seven rounds.
Mayweather, there's fights where people think they lost. He lost. So that lets you know that he didn't look impressive in those fights, so everybody has those bad fights.
That's true. I think Abner's coming out with his own hair products.
Huh?
You have your own hair products.
I am. I'm going to start. Yeah.
All right. We're going to let you know. We're going to do a whole video on it when it's coming out. But Abner Mars is going to have his own.
And I just finished sparring.
He just finished sparring and his hair still looks solid. He's fighting at StubHub. Yes.
Yo, talking about that, there's people comment like, yo, Abner, you should worry less about your hair and train more. Like, what do you think? I'm just at home, like, doing my hair. It takes me all day to do my hair. I do my hair, and that's it. I go work out. Like, I work out.
You do two a day, sometimes three a day. Abner's working very hard. He knows this is a tough fight. All fights are tough, but he could have chosen.
People want boxers not to look good. People want boxers to be all ball-headed. Like, if I take care of myself physically, like you know, that's on me. I'm still working.
They want you to fit in a certain box, to fit a certain image.
Yeah, exactly.
But you know, Roger Mayweather told me a few years ago, if a fighter's loud, let him be loud. If a fighter curses, let him curse. Let people be themselves. Don't change them. Is it true you cut your hair with Jonathan Deluxe in Bell, California?
Yeah.
Someone said it on the live.
Yeah, I cut it.
You got people stalking you.
I cut it 3 times a week, bro. I got them on payroll. I swear. People are like, you cut your hair, like, bro. Got them on payroll. Taxi does.
Abner, if Robert made a comeback and he had to choose someone to work his corner that's not his dad, who should he pick? Which trainer?
Me.
You would work his corner?
Me. I'm a good, bro, I'm a good cornerman. Like, I know how to give advice to the corner.
Do you think you guys would be on a winning streak?
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna fight for TJ. Easy fight.
Robert, what do you weigh right now? 175?
More.
No.
I'm weighing myself
right. Let's weigh yourself right now. Let's see. Let's see what you weigh, Robert.
More.
200? No.
180, 185.
Okay, 175. Him and who's 175? Him and Gvozdik?
Oh, man.
That'll be a tough fight, huh?
Coach is he's a hell of a coach. He's got we're talking about how many fights you got, coach, in within like how many months range and all that?
49 days, 5 title fights.
When? You?
Yeah.
That's crazy. Days, how could that be? That's 1 month and 2 weeks.
26.
Okay.
Josito. February 9, Abner. February 10, Jose Ramirez. February 16, Icona. March 16, Mikey. 49 days, 5 world title fights.
Wow.
Plus all the other guys that are also going to be fighting.
And your own card on the 18th.
Crazy. Yeah, and then on the 26th, that same day, Virgil and Frank are gonna fight in Texas, remember?
That's true.
And Bisael is gonna fight in Mexico that same day.
Very, very busy. Sorry, autocorrect sometimes fixes it. So you have your hands full?
That's why this team is the best team in the world.
Oh, did you get fired at Trainer of the Year? Is it official?
Know. I have no idea. I don't pay attention to that.
I think Usyk got Fighter of the Year.
Without no doubt, he deserves to get that. Fighter of the Year. No, but 49 world title, I mean, 5 world title fights in 49
that's
days.
That's crazy. I think that has to be a Guinness Book of Records.
Well, it is.
The most title fights in one period.
For one team.
The
yeah.
WBC keep track of Guinness Book of Records.
Who does?
WBC.
Oh, yeah?
At their convention, they give out awards.
Five title fights in 49 days. That's only title fights, not including all the other fights that are going to be happening. Like, Franco's fighting for the NABF title. Lindolfo's going to, I mean, Misael's going to fight that same day. So is Virgil Ortiz fighting that same day. And then we got other guys that I'm sure are also going to be fighting in between those days. But five world title fights in 49 days.
When is Mikey starting to train here?
End of January. Yeah. End of January.
Are you guys both studying Errol Spence a lot?
Not yet.
Are you watching Errol Spence?
Está mirando Errol Spence, papá. Está mirando un poquito. He's seen him fight.
What does he see?
Que mira.
He's
very good. Very strong. When he's the one coming to attack, he's a very strong fighter.
Southpaw.
Zurdo.
Strong.
Tiene sus ventajas porque está más grande, más pesado.
He's got his advantages. He's bigger, he's heavier.
Why does he think, why did Mikey want this fight?
¿Usted por qué piensa que Mikey quiso esta pelea?
Ah, porque yo pienso que es que Mike quiere ponerse a prueba en un rey.
Mike wants to challenge himself. For a big challenge, he wants to challenge himself.
Él igual que yo miramos que tenemos
We see that we have one of the best qualities in boxing to beat him.
Todo el tiempo a un peleador muy fuerte se le ha ganado con talento.
All the time with a fighter that strong, you beat him with the talent.
O sea, es la cualidad más.
That's the best quality to have to beat a fighter.
Can you give me an example from boxing history of something similar?
Un ejemplo en la historia del boxeo o algo similar de un boxeador así.
Claro que sí. Hay muchos peleadores que han logrado. Hay quienes son Mayweather, no, luego él no era más grande que nadie. Era, casi siempre le peleaba con desventajas de peso a todos y de fuerza.
Perfect example is Mayweather. Mayweather always moved up in weight. Always gave a lot of weight advantages when Mayweather fought. He would always, you know, he gained 2 or 3 pounds when the other guys gained 20, and he still beat him. Why? Pacquiao did the same thing. Pacquiao was very small and moved up and beat welterweights, junior middleweights. Leonard did the same.
They're saying that Mikey Spence is like Mayweather's Sugar Leonard and Manny Pacquiao's fight.
Pacquiao, Mayweather, Leonard, moving up in weight, and talent. Yeah, that's what they've shown, their talent. My dad thinks that in strength, my dad doesn't think that we have that much of a disadvantage.
And lo único que veo que sí va a llevar más libras.
Pounds, the weight is going to be a problem. That's going to be the difference.
Esas se eliminan con el talento.
That you eliminate that with talent.
It's a lot of people think Mikey's a big underdog. Does he agree or not?
¿Usted qué piensa? Que todo el mundo piensa que Mikey es pues el underdog, no es el favorito. Pues
tienen razón.
They have good reason.
Es un buen amigo, pero nosotros tenemos confianza.
But we have a confidence
en nosotros mismos.
Ourselves, Mikey.
Que vamos.
That we're gonna do it.
Mikey's a special fighter, a 4-division fighter, 39-0. What does he need to do in this fight?
Mikey es un peleador especial, 39-0. ¿Qué es lo que tiene que hacer?
¿Con esta pelea? No debemos muy bien de publicar qué vamos a hacer.
I can't tell you what we're gonna do.
No, not the game plan, but you know what he needs to do.
Pero sí sabemos lo que va a hacer. Claro, we do know.
And then,
mira, también parece. Mira, se un peleador que es muy fuerte es porque va para adelante. Va para atrás, ya no tiene la misma
fuerza. A fighter that's very strong. That's very strong. If you let him come forward, then he's fucking strong. He's gonna. But my dad says like Canelo against Triple G. Canelo backed Triple G up, and that in Triple G wasn't as strong anymore.
Y lo dije antes de la pelea.
And said it, and my dad said it before the fight. If Canelo does that, that's the best way to do it.
By the way, you guys hear Canelo might fight Triple G again in May for the third time.
Canelo va a pelear con Triple G otra vez en mayo. Canelo beats him.
Hasta lo puede noquear.
Last time he couldn't even stop him. My dad said, "Even knock him out."
Knock him out. Do you agree, Robert?
I think he'll probably win another decision, but this time it'll be no question, no doubt, no robbery, none of that bullshit.
By the way, did you see Oscar De La Hoya's post on Christmas Eve? He said, for all the people who support me, I love you, and if you're a hater, go F yourself.
Well, I didn't see that. He was probably having a good time.
And then,
he was probably having a good time.
You saw Miss Phelps?
No, what?
Tell me whether corrected his spelling.
Well, Floyd corrected De La Hoya's spelling?
I didn't see that.
So De La Hoya misspelled some things? Oscar misspelled some things?
Like a lot of things.
And he was having a good time. Yeah. He was having a good time.
What's up?
What do you think about it? How's it going?
And then Mayweather corrected. Mayweather can't even spell. And he corrected it.
Right here.
Let me see that shit.
That's the first one. If you swipe, is the one corrected.
By the way, Robert, so John Jones was supposed to fight in Vegas, right?
Yeah, I know.
This weekend.
Hey, with this, you seen it, right?
Yeah.
Mayweather
learn to spell. learn to spell. And De La Hoya, he's a smart man. He was just having a good time at that time when he wrote that, right? He was probably having a good time. So can't blame him.
But was he talking about Dana White? Was he talking about somebody else? Who was he referring to as the hater? Because him and Dana White were getting into it recently, and he said
well,
that...
Because, you know, like...
Oh, is it him and Floyd?
Like Mayweather knows and thinks, you know, thinks and knows that they have a lot of haters. De La Hoya, same thing. He knows there's a lot of haters. Dana White, but...
Is it Floyd that he's talking
Dana
about?
White is hating. I think Dana White is just trying to prove that he's got facts. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mayweather has a lot of haters. De La Hoya has a lot of haters.
We all have a lot of haters.
We all do. Everybody.
I think I have more haters than anybody else here in this room right now.
Everybody does. Everybody has haters.
Yeah, I agree with that.
But it is what it is.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
By the way, where is Josecito? You coming in?
He comes at 2:00.
And then, so John Jones, check this out. Was supposed to fight in Vegas this weekend. The commission did not allow him to fight
this
there.
Coming weekend?
Yes, so he's fighting at the Forum. They found in his system one, let's say you take a grain of salt and you chop it up to 50 million parts. So that one of those 50 million is what they found in his system.
Of what?
Of some kind of steroid.
Oh, yeah?
But he says that was from 2 years ago. So they determined it's not, but still the commission in Vegas. So why sometimes they let a fighter fight and sometimes they don't? How do they decide in Vegas who fights and who doesn't?
I don't know.
Because the commission in California lets him. They say he was clean. It wasn't anything. I don't know how it works.
Yeah, I don't know how that shit works. I really don't know how that shit works.
But that's crazy. One out of 50 million.
Wow. Why would they even... look? Why would they... But it was there.
No, because now I'm sure the laboratories and the... microscopes or whatever they use is much more advanced than it was 5-10 years ago. But they
it
said
was there, but that was
it was
there.
There, and they said it's left over from 2 years ago. It stayed in the system.
It's there.